Hello and welcome back to Rollercoaster Tycoon, where this lovely garden-esque park because that's what it is, it's a park in a park, is the last scenario that we're doing in the Corkscrew Follies expansion. And so far, we are quite on target. There is a guest coming in the park, and we are officially above the target that we set ourselves. Now, currently, it is almost the end of August. That means that we got September and October to reel in even more guests than we really need. So, well, that is at least on the agenda. Now, as it currently stands, at the end of August, things like, you know, our rituals become more important. And a viewer actually pointed out that there is a very clever method to do a thing that I usually do manually by just, you know, rummaging around the park in a very specific view. And that is our pricing check. What we could do is open up the rides list here, go to profit, and then sort, and negative ones are the ones that are not used. And I believe that popularity 0 will show the same thing. So the round corona and the trifactum are the ones without... yeah, it's true actually. It is actually true. All right. Well, whoever it was, thank you very much for pointing this out. This will be my preferred method of usage. So, let's see here. We need to lower you to, let's say, about 150. That should at least have you make some profit. And the round corona, this definitely needs to be lowered, and we will lower this to 70 cents there. That's not much, and every guest will be able to afford that. Now, there isn't really any quick way of getting just some kind of, you know, shortlist over here sorted to find out how the vandalism is. We still need to do that by hand. So there we go. Let's see. So far so good, I guess. Even in the underground, how's it doing there? Yeah, looking fine. Looking just fine. And then... further down here, it all seems pretty good, and this is of course new area, so if something was demolished over here, I'd be quite surprised. Seems that the guests are pretty well behaved in this one. That's good, good. Now, another good thing about using this for, the pricing check is that we can see which rides are earning us the most, and I was just about to say... wow, oh man. Anyway, so let's get the view back to normal, which is like this. Now, when we speak about ride balance, I am talking about the mix of rides in our park. And what I mean by that is the balance between tracked rides and slammed down rides. Now, currently, it's 4-on-4. That's kind of okay-ish, but at least in the early game, these slam down rides usually have a little bit of an advantage. And seeing how over here, there aren't that many tracked rides. In fact, there's only... there aren't that many slam down rides. There's only tracked rides, and there's actually only pretty intense tracked rides. I have a feeling that over here we need to get ourselves a slam down gentle ride to keep the balance in that stuff, and perhaps also get one down over here, though that doesn't really necessarily need to be a slam down gentle ride. It could also be a thrill one, but at least over here I want a gentle ride. So we're gonna get that right over here, and I'm actually thinking that See, over here, when we take a look at the water rides, we don't have all of them available, but I'm assuming that because this is the last park and we need a hell of a lot of rides, the devs will have thought of that too. So I'm assuming that we're gonna get them all, you know, it's a bit of a hunch because I don't really know, but that means that we're gonna get the river rapids and the river ride, and I kind of want both over here. So we're not going to build any more water rides over here. So I'm not that, you know, it's not really that big a problem for me to just build some gentle rides above the water. And the same is really true for any other slam down ride, really. I don't mind. Also don't mind filling that up with coasters, really. It's just saying there's not gonna be any other water ride over here. So, well, what gentle ride is it going to be then, huh? You know what we could do? We don't have it available. I was about to say, you know what we could do? We could actually build a maze over here, but the maze isn't there, so what we could also do is build a tower. Huh. Tower is actually a pretty solid idea. We could build that jack square in this corner over here. And then, well, yeah, and then we have so many rides, really. You know what? It's gonna be the tower. It's gonna be over here, and it's gonna be overlooking the whole freaking park. Maybe it's better to build that stuff in the center, actually. Yeah. I don't know. You know, it's not gonna be the tower. We have the carousel. We have the crab ride. It's gonna be one of these houses, I think. Yeah, that's much better. No. You know what it's gonna be? Well, make up your mind, dammit. It's gonna be the lighthouse, because it's at the water. Why didn't I think of that before? Right, so the lighthouse. Yeah, well, I know it's spiral slide, but oh, yeah, sure, it's not allowed. Here it is. Good. Now, that is going to mean that we're gonna have this over here. And then this over there. Now we'll quickly remove this stretch of path purely for our exit so it hooks up nicely without opening up the whole next area of the park. There. We'll then get ourselves you out there. Right, now that's not really where I would want you to be, so I guess that isn't where I want you to be either. But hey, we're gonna do with it, so there. Right, now, no, that's not what I want. Good, so we will quickly set this up, this lighthouse. Now we're not gonna, no, it is a lighthouse, but like I said, we're not going to go with descriptionary names, so, and the slide one is no exception. Now, why don't we call this, yeah, well, you know what, we're gonna call this the beacon, instead of the beacon, because, well, you know, a lighthouse is a kind of beacon, we're gonna call it the beacon. Ah, so clever, so clever. And then, what we're gonna do with the coloring is, we are gonna color it beacon style. So I guess that would be like this, and then perhaps this with, no, we need white tiles, I think. No, now it doesn't look like bacon anyway, but bacon always has some grease in it. I guess this, grease? Grease would be white, wouldn't it? But now it's, we need this to be three colors, dang it. Alright, you know what, just to try and get that out there. Oh, no, that's the same color. Balls. Alright, we'll go with plain style then. I don't like this. We need perhaps this. How does this look? I'll mix this up a bit. This is mightily greasy bacon. This is like English bacon, you know, what they eat for breakfast. I don't know, really. I don't know. Also, it seems they've forgotten the name I've given it. The bacon. There. No, you know what? Screw the grease. We're gonna have light bacon, like proper Danish bacon. I don't know, I never ate Danish bacon, but hey, that is besides the point. And I will have this be there, yeah. The bacon. Oh, that's quite the cool name. Right, so, now that we got that sorted, what we do need is this over there. Yeah, alright. So far, so good, and look at that. It seems that we just got ourselves our very first thunderstorm. Wow, now I'm curious, are the guests going on? Yes! Look! This coaster here is now considered rainproof. Something that all the other rides aren't really. I mean, I'm talking about a plunger there. That's not rainproof. This coaster is, so even when it's raining, we will still be making some money. Albeit not as much as we would before, but I don't wonder though, this has 12 tubs. What do we have in terms of ride time? 1 minute 25. That's about 80 seconds, so I guess if we have 5 seconds, which is just about right, loading time, then yeah, we're actually golden. Nice! Alrighty. Now, what we need next is basically a coaster, but we are on max loan, are we not? I mean, yep, we're definitely on max loan. And in terms of coasters, oh, yes, yes, yes. Oh, wow. This is so what we need. I was thinking about building this one, but this is the one that we need. This is it. This will be the coaster that we're going to build next. However, for this one, I do believe and I do feel that we need, like, more money. Ideally, we'd have, like, around 5 or 6 grand when we start building it, so yeah. You know what? In the meantime, whilst we're waiting for that, we will build, like, a thrill ride over here. Yeah. It doesn't really, I mean, if we think about the bigger planning, I mean, let's zoom out just a little bit. Wow, look at this. It's August, and all we did was fill up 20% of the park, really. That's not a whole lot, to be honest. I mean, we have this all available to fill up. Most of it's going to be tracked rides. I think that all the slam down rides are going to come till here, and then it's tracked rides only. It's not that I mind, don't get me wrong, but I'm just saying, you know, that's how it's going to be, most likely. Oh, nice, alright. Well, actually, you know what, I think perhaps we should do a little bit of scenery here and there. And yeah, you know what, we're going to do some scenery, get some fountains down, just to save up some money. And once we got that covered, then we will build the coaster. So, let's see. Fountains, huh? I mean, this is good to do. It will increase the overall park rating, you know. It will also increase the ride ratings, so there's no argument against it. And there are fountains. I mean, that's an argument in and of itself. Right, I don't want to overdo it with them, but oh, yeah, what did I just say? Right, so that's that. We then also need some more of these jumping fountains, actually. So, we'll just get a few where we don't have any yet. Like over there, guests really like jumping fountains. I wouldn't say that that's something that they come to the park for, but they really appreciate it. This we will have many. Many and plenty of jumping fountains. Now, I quite like them. I think they're cheerful and bounce. So, there we go. Look at this. Oh, man, the guests are digging this. I know, I mean, I would dig it myself, so that's usually a good indication of whether or not we should have it. And I will build a few more here. I don't want to replace any benches and whatnot that I have had placed already, so it's just going to be complimentary, you know. But seeing how I usually just randomly smack them everywhere, there's bound to be some empty places, you know, when it comes to these. So. Right, well. Wow, it seems that the guests are actually wildly attracted to our jumping fountains, and they come in droves to them. Now then, now that the rain's gone and we sold plenty of umbrellas for good money, you know what? Let's plan out this next coaster, right? That we're gonna build. Now, I have in mind a place for this, and we're looking at it right now. See, when I was saying that there's plenty of space in between this coast, I wasn't lying. What my intention here is to get this coaster, this steel mini coaster, because I can already give you that much info. What I want is for that one to go, like, maybe a little bit over here. I don't want it to go all the way over to this hill. I want it to go over here, and then, if possible, you know, go in between, and then go through. No, go through here. What am I thinking? Ah, well, actually, if we take a look, this is height 10. Let's do this with the supports disabled as well as the scenery to keep everything a bit clear. This is height 10, this is height 15, so it's easy to go above these tracks, below these. That's doable. Actually, there's margin even there. And we could go to height 10 in a curve. Yeah. I guess there are possibilities. And if we take a look in the underground, it's not that there's that much out there. I mean, sure, there's this little track, but we could just avoid it by going below it. I mean, anything below height 7 is free rooming for us, really, on this side. There isn't much there. So perhaps this coaster is gonna have just a, you know, just going up, you know, going up, going down, do maybe a helix or something, you know, just a one-off thingy, and then go up here with the lift proper, go to cool heights, do a drop, and then we are gonna do this. It could be a total mistake on my part, and we could waste valuable time with this, but I'm gonna take the gamble. So here's the plan, huh? It will be a lot of talking before we actually get to a building, but the coaster is gonna be below over here. Now, it's going to be below this toilet area, and the station is going to be that far back that we're going to be going up on these sloped areas here. So that's where we're going to surface. And then I'm going to go further up. We could even curve it. But we don't really need to. We need to go up with a curve at some point, of course. Maybe even curve it twice. I don't really see why we would do that. I mean, the main lift's going to be over here anyway. So we go up, we go down. We're going to keep it low. It's crucial. So we're going to keep it low and then do a helix or something. We can't. If we can go below the path, that would be bonkers mad, you know. We could try, I guess. Height 7 should be okay. I mean, if I'm willing to modify the water for that one. So we're going to do some shenanigan over here, and then we're going to go up here. Now, the question is where. My intention is to go up here, and then perhaps curve it in the lift. We can do that with this coaster, that's the beauty of it. So perhaps curve it, and then we are going to go straight and simple to this area over here. We're not going to try and do cool shenanigans. No, we're going to try and go safe to the area, and then what we want to do is we want to go, let's get them supports out. What we want to do is we want to go underground on this corner bit over here, which should be right besides the path and this car track. And yeah, so basically, wait, where this tree is at, that's gonna be the mark for going underground, or at least the aim. We might not miss it, we might miss it. If that's so, then we need to have a plan B in that area. Well, hold on a second. Of course there's a plan B. If the tree doesn't work, we could move that whole shenanigan to the side by one, and we have plenty of room and headway. Yeah, all right. So this is gonna happen. It's not really a question of if, it's more a question of where. Right. Okay. So then in the underground, I feel like I've got free play to do whatever I want below this hill, because this hill I consider to be mostly taken. So yeah, the plan's there. By the way, look at the country, man. I mean, it's 32 degrees in September. I mean, global warming? It's not a lie. Right, so yeah, we're gonna build this coaster. And oh man. Now, the eggheads, they are designing yet another roller coaster, and depending on what that one is, like if it's completely useless, we'll have to get yet another coaster. But if it is useful, you know, in that we are gonna build it, well, the only useless coaster, or the only coaster I'd consider useless, is the brother of this one with the added track piece, which is equally lame, and the herd line coaster, or the herd line, hard line, whatever you call it, hard line coaster. Because I don't know how it works, and I haven't figured it out after trying three or four times. So yeah. But if it's any other coaster, we might want to switch what those eggheads are doing. So I'll have to keep an eye on this message board there. Now, the steel mini coaster then, huh? Let's first of all do some terraforming over here, because that is going to be our entrance point. Like so, and then we need to build this backwards. So that means no backwards. That means going up. That translates to going down. And then I guess height 7 is it. We don't really need much more doing. No, we don't. On the other hand, we do because of issues with the entrance. So I guess height 4 it is then. I don't really know. How much further can I go back over here? Alright. Huh. Okay. Can this happen? It can. Nice. Well, in that case, that's that sorted. We do need the exit to be at the end. Don't really want that. It's not ideal for a repeat guest. But that's how it's gonna be. So, now that we have this in working order, we will remove these and replace them with lifted pieces, like so. Well, I guess, yeah, I mean, we can just have this be like this. This isn't really that much of an issue, really. Okay, maybe it is. Can that happen? This can happen though, and I know the trains are long enough to make that. Right, now these trees, they all need to be gone, so there we go, we'll remove them. We don't really need to go up any further when it comes to height, so there. And then right now, yeah, I guess a good drop down is all that we need. Right. Nice. Now that is path height, huh? So I wonder, I mean, can we even, yeah, we can even do this. How cool. I guess what we would need then is for this whole shenanigan is to be pulled in by one. So I guess what we would really need is for this just to be a tight curve. Then do it like this. I mean, we don't really need that extra height over there. It doesn't really serve a purpose other than for coolness, you know? So Alright, now we do need to have this go straight a little longer. Like this. And then... I guess this would do. Oh, then they found it anyway. Alright, so we do need the tight curve there. Doesn't, that also gives us more leeway to play around over here as well. But look at that, man. Isn't that bonkers? Yes, it is. Wow. Nice. Helix down. Helix up large. That's not allowed. It's probably because of the path, actually. If I were to go up one further... And then do a helix up large. It's because of the slide in the way. Right. Helix down small then? It's gonna... Yeah, moan about the fountain. Ah, that's a shame. Right. Fine. No. We will have to go over here. Do we helix up small? No, we don't. So... Alright, let's plan this out a little bit. I want a helix over here. So, having said that, what I guess we would need for that is for this fountain and for this track to just move to the side one. However, that's going to require an S-bend, or we do a big... one with you know, those mellow curves. So if I do the calculations on that one, we need one straight, and then it's like no, that's not gonna work out. An S bend is a G killer, so we can't have that, not when we come from height. I guess we're not going that fast, but no, that's not gonna happen. Maybe I just need to skip the whole helix thing and come up with something else cool. How about this? Okay, how about not that? That should do it. We should probably lift this last curve here. Do a drop like you. Right, that ain't gonna work, but balls. Right, so let's see here. And then something rather tight like that. Roller coaster in the way. Right now we could go down there. And then if we were to go up steep. Right now we're above the other coaster. Alright. So we did a cool shenanigan here, or whether it was cool, I guess what we did was we just basically weaved the track through itself. In a way, I don't know really. It's not what I was hoping for, but it's there. So yeah, what we got over here is the track going up, not at the desired spot, but I do believe that we could just, and I want to do that like somewhere around here, curve it to over here, and then we'll probably have a drop right around this boat. In a curved fashion, I'll have to take a look at the height markers. But so far, the plan is to go above this, below over here, then also below the bridge above these tracks, and then in a curve leading us right up there. That's the plan. Let's see if we can get that properly executed, alright? This is the plan. Now currently we're at height 19. I guess we could go up one further, but there's no real need for it. Alright. Oh no. Right. The safest park in the country! We got an award! Yay! It's not that hard to achieve that. So. Alright, that's looking promising. Could I do that straight on? No. Also not like that. So that is indeed the only option. Alright, let's see where that leads us. Can we... Alright, that doesn't lead to any place good. If I were to extend that by one further though... Would I... No. Alright, let's rethink this quickly. So the whole curve go through there is not happening because it's difficult, I guess. I guess what we would need then is a sharp and deep drop. Though maybe the path isn't even an issue. Let's get the path markers out there. Type 12, I guess. Nah, there isn't the possibility to go through this loop, so we won't even try. Hold on a second. Yeah, alright. So, we are right now good to go above this. I don't want that. Perhaps if I drop steep. What are the options if I do that? Nope. No steep drops. And what if I do it like this, and then drop steep. Yep. Right, this is annoying. So perhaps this whole point over here isn't on the right thing, you know? Maybe we would need to... Because the thing is, I do have more space over here, so you know what? What we're gonna do is we're gonna try to get this one higher. So there. I guess that was too higher, but alright, fine. Look, alright now. Yeah, now we still run into issues. But, no, game, no, just straight, and then, now this is what we would want. Yes, alright, so we got this working, and I don't think that this will be too intense, speed wouldn't be that high, so, right, now what we want is a mellow curve, around there. Perfect. And you know what? Well, even extended being, straight or horizontal on our screen, but there. Right, now. Alright, and we can go through over there. Very nice. I don't know if we're gonna... We don't even hit any issues over here. Well, let's rotate the view so that we can see what we're doing. Nice. Right. Why don't I keep this view on here? Ah, that's a shame. I mean, at height 11, we're just golden to go below everything, really. You know, ideally... If we weren't this far out here, which there's no real reason to be actually, so why don't we pull this one in a little? Go to height 11, which we were at just a moment ago, and discover that there were reasons to be there. But I guess we could go even lower. Now, I do wonder... Alright, so the fountain is in the way. I guess for a coaster as majestic as this one, The fountain will make place without much issues. By the way, do we even need to be... Yeah, alright. There is a reason to be at height 11, but that's alright. Oh, yeah, to be there even one earlier. Right. Then, like that. And right now, we are at our plan B spot, but that's fine. Because our plan B spot works just as well as our plan A spot. And it's plan B for a reason. Now, look at what we have over here. Nice curve with plenty of space in the underground to do whatever we want. We might kind of have missed our station already, but we can get back there anytime. So, what we're gonna do... Now, I know that our money isn't that great, so... We'll have a helix down large. A helix down small. A helix down large. And then we are below our station height by one. That's alright now. We'll go up by one. Because we can. You know what, we might even straighten that out in a banked curve. And I don't really know how we line up over here. So I could be totally off, but look at that! Oh my, oh my. And we got the mine train coaster. Oh, I think I might have missed one, because I think that our eggheads... I don't think the mine train... Yeah. I wouldn't consider this useless, nor would I consider these. Both of them aren't useless. This one's tricky, though. But we can build these. That's not an issue, though. We don't need more, so... There. We'll put it back to throw right still. That's all developed. For now, look at this. Another coaster. And... Well, it's actually... It's a bit of a non-standard design in that we usually build them curvy in the same spot. Well, this one is also curvy, but it's not in the same spot, and it's a bit... I don't know. I don't know if it will be any good or not. Ooh, look at this, though. We have more options. Though, roller coaster car, rocket car... Hold on a second. Let's not test right that straight away. Let's see. Rocket cars... We get 4 trains, that's like, 12. Alright, hold on, we need to do math here, and we all know that I'm horrible at it. So that's 6 times 4 is 24 in total. Now, log cars is 3, 10, yeah, this is 60 in total. And this is the same. But we're gonna go with logs because it's different. And it's cool. So there we go. Got that sorted. Hopefully this coaster will be equally as good as all the other ones. If not, it will be around equal of the rest. So it should be around this mark. But that's not bad. It doesn't need to be like ultra good. Well, actually it does. But for it to contribute to the park... It's alright if it's, you know, just a sixer in the ratings. Now, having set that up, let's test ride it. And, yeah, let's first come up with a name, and then I'll, you know, color paint it, and then I will hook it up whilst you can watch the test ride. So, seeing how these are logs, you know, on wheels, I mean, how could we possibly call it other than logs on wheels? How about, we call this, yeah, I mean, it's also a combination of wood and steel. So, how about we call this steel wood? I don't know, really, wood steel? Yeah, you know what? We're gonna call this wood. We're gonna call this wood steel. Oh yeah, alright. That's a good one. I like that. That's original. It's good. Now, let's color paint this, and you know what? Great supports, I guess. There's something to be said for it. I don't like it so much, so what we'll do instead, we'll go with the red. Oh yeah, that looks good, man. This coaster can totally handle red supports. It's a good choice, if I may say so. Green inside bars, those will do. A bright red track, I don't like that. Instead, I'm thinking that perhaps a yellow, maybe even a brighter yellow. This makes it so Jamaican-like. No, we're not gonna have that. Black, perhaps? Back to black? Ah, black would do. How does white look? That's actually grey. I was about to say, like, this is a suspiciously grey type of white. I guess the white also doesn't look so bad. There's more colours. How about a golden? I don't like golden. Icy blue? Nah. Nah, that doesn't fit. Nor does that, because of the other coaster. I like the black. Black it is, then. And we are going to go with quite contrastary colours with yellow and white, so we will have quite bright... I was about to say vessels, but log trains. Now, having said the word log, I immediately remember what we were actually doing. And that is having logs on wheels. So, yeah, this is a light type of wood, you know, some, I don't know, American oak or something like it. So, yeah, now, let's test ride this, and you guys watch train 1, and or train 2, or train 3, no, train 1, because he's up front. And now I'm gonna bother myself with hooking this up, and that actually will require some planning. But what I'm thinking is that we're gonna have quite a long one hooking this up. Let's see. Alright, let's just get this show on the road. We need to be driving. We'll probably find terrain issues, but that's alright. If I go up any further, yeah, then we do hit terrain issues. Alright. Now we also do. That's okay. Let's go down, like so. And that's hooked up. Quite a nice length, I must admit, but... a bit low and... oh no. Oh wow, that's spot on. Now let's pause this and let's see what the how and where I could and want to hook this up. It's not that difficult actually, really. All I need to go is to the side and do one of those same tricks that I did over here with this queue. That's what we're gonna do. So, I guess that means going over here. So we would need to go up by 2. And then, in reality, I'm already too far out. One. Hold on a second. Is that allowed? No. I don't know if height mark is out there. What are they? I can't even see this. Height 6 and 7, huh? So, I guess if I were to just go straight, just like that, boom. That doesn't hook it up now, does it? Hold on a second. Balls, it doesn't. Alright, remove and redo this properly. There. Alright, never happened a thing over here. I guess what I would need is for this to go straight, and then just enable this again. Yeah, this is where we need to go. Look, see? There. Look at that. Perfect. All hooked up nicely and tidy. Rightio. So, wow, look at the speed at which that coaster is traveling, man. It's crazy. Now, I do believe that that is the second test ride that we've done. So, it should be complete, but I have a hunch that it might be too extreme. Not! It is actually... It is way above the expectations, if I'm honest. Oh my good lord, look at that. It's a 6.7 for... Well, I'd consider it a cheap coaster, really. Freaking high ratings. How is this one? The plunger. It's not affected at all in the slightest. And you? The nano coaster? I don't think it's affected that much, but wow, all our coasters so far are like around 7, so I guess that's pretty solid actually. Wow! Okay then, good stuff. We'll up the pricing a little bit, and yeah, nice! Now that is good news. You know, like, I remember seeing in the very first video of this park that it's gonna be, you know, everything needs to be right. We cannot afford a single mistake. This coaster, you know, was the most iffy of all the ones we've built so far, and it turns out to be a proper success. Nice! Ah, yeah! I done it again! So, let's quickly get this stuff sorted. I mean, it's important. We need this. It needs to be in place. Ah, man, that's a relief, man. Now, you know, currently what we're gonna do and what we really need is some staff expansion. You need to take care of this new area there. And we also need a fix mechanic, which will be you. Now, I don't know if I... Alright, so that's the square there, right at that where the marshmallow and the car meet, that's where you need to be assigned. So you'll only fix rides. Alright, I guess that's that. But we're also going to get a new one, you know, just a loose mechanic. And I feel that right now is the time to hire a guard, even though I haven't spotted any vandalism. The same is true for the entertainers. I feel like right now we need them, so there we are. Very, very good, this. I absolutely like how this park is going. It is doing great, you know, the operation is smooth. We're making lots and lots of money, and it looks typically damaged, though. But, yeah, this is... It's exciting, man. So, well, with almost no money left and 700 guests at the end of year one, I guess it's time to think carefully about how we're going to expand, because money is an issue. But how we're going to tackle that issue is something you'll find out, yeah, you guessed it, next time when we play more Rollercoaster Tycoon.